By alloying their steels with an ever-changing list of specific elements such as manganese, titanium, chromium, and nickel, automakers are making practically constant upgrades to vehicle engines and structures. However, for electric vehicles, the key formula for making the physics in electric motors and batteries work might be challenging. Answer: for today's episode, we are going to share with you the newly improved electric motor of Toyota that will definitely shock the EV industry. One of the crucial components in e-motors is neodymium, which is one of the most important elements in the rare earth magnets required to make the permanent magnet electric motors seen in today's electric vehicles. Toyota intends to reduce its dependency on neodymium as it advances in the development of a global electric vehicle. Permanent magnet motors, which are used in the Prius Prime and most EVs and hybrids, are named after magnets that are mounted directly on or within the rotor, the rotating component of the motor, while electric current is applied to the windings of the stator, the stationary component of the motor. Rare earth magnets, which are lighter and can produce a stronger field, and consequently greater torque, than old-style ferrite magnets, are used to generate the power required for EVs. There are various motor designs, such as the AC induction motors used in Tesla's Model S and Model X, or the current excited motors being developed by several manufacturers for next-generation EVs. However, the ease of production and effectiveness of the permanent magnet system keep automakers returning to it, even Tesla in its Model 3. Toyota has discovered an approach to lower the quantity of neodymium in electric motor magnets by 20%, with the potential to reduce it by up to 50%, while retaining the heat-resistant properties that have made the metal so popular. The grain surface of the magnets has been totally rebuilt, and the automaker has gone to a two-layer structure that places concentrated neodymium on the surface but a diluted form of the element in the core, alloying it within in a 3-to-1 ratio with cerium and lanthanum. Both of these new elements, according to the company, are abundant and reasonably inexpensive. The new magnet's performance, in terms of coercivity, is marginally better at the top of its operating temperature range, above about 270 degrees Fahrenheit, which is exactly where and when peak performance in an electric car is required. Toyota intends to use the new magnets in electric power steering systems in the next few years, and in drive motors for electric automobiles over the next 10 years. Not in scarcity, but in scarcity of supplies. There are concerns that shortages will develop as electrified vehicles, including hybrid and battery electric vehicles, become increasingly popular in the future, Toyota stated in a press release. Despite this, there has been little effort made to address neodymium use. It is in short supply and is one of 14 metals listed in a 2012 research as requiring 1% or more of total 2010 world supply every year between 2020 and 2030. The anticipated rise in the green energy sector, which requires rare earth magnets for motors and generators, is driving the increase in demand for neodymium and other elements such as cadmium, dysprosium, gallium, and vanadium, among others. The phrase, rare earth, is virtually a misnomer since, while most rare earth elements are abundant in the earth, they are difficult to separate from other minerals. The majority of neodymium currently originates from China, where the authorities cracked down on illegal mines earlier this year, sending the element's price rising. If nothing is done to minimize the industry's reliance on specific materials, we may simply be exchanging one dependency for another. Rare earths in EVs: problems, solutions, and what is actually happening. The problem. The supply chain for rare earths is geographically severely restricted. China produces the largest bulk of the world's output, which has historically resulted in price instability. China prohibited rare earth shipments in 2011, resulting in price increases of approximately 750% and 2,000% for neodymium and dysprosium, respectively. Prices have been mostly consistent subsequently, with the exception of a 1.5-fold spike in 2017 due to environmental reforms in China. 2021 is proving to be the most volatile year yet, with a 2.2-fold spike at the start of the year that has yet to stabilize. Aside from price considerations, there are environmental concerns. Rare earths are collected from ores that may contain radioactive minerals such as thorium, and the process of extracting rare earths often involves the use of carcinogenic substances such as ammonia, hydrochloric acids, and sulfates. It is projected that processing 1 ton of rare earths can result in up to 2,000 tons of harmful waste. Something has to change in order for EVs to actually be a shift to green technology. The solution. Permanent magnet machines are the most common type of electric drive motor, but certain designs do not require permanent magnets, and thus rare earths. The induction motor has a copper or aluminum cage on its rotor. This design has already been employed by Tesla for its Model S and X. Renault, for example, has used a wound rotor arrangement with copper windings on the rotor. Some, particularly in the heavy-duty or commercial vehicle categories, are choosing for the switching reluctance motor, which has a silicon steel rotor and does not require magnets or copper on the rotor. Permanent magnet motors often have higher power density and efficiency, which is why so many people use them. In addition to eliminating the magnets, efforts are being made to minimize the rare earth or heavy rare earth composition of the magnets. OEMs like Honda and Nissan have decreased or eliminated the hefty rare earth component. Four alternatives to rare earth elements, rare earth element, usage. Several novel alternatives are being developed with the goal of replacing or reducing the United States' dependency on rare earth elements. The following are some examples, although keep in mind that many are centered on magnetic applications, as permanent supermagnets are the most popular rare earth element application. Meteorite magnets. Tetratinite, a natural iron-nickel alloy with persistent magnetism, was identified in iron meteorites in 1980. Tetratinite is extremely rare in terrestrial rocks and is nearly entirely supplied from meteorites, rendering it effectively useless for commercial application, that is, until scientists discovered a way to synthesize the mineral. Northeastern University's College of Engineering received a patent in late 2022 for a novel technique of manufacturing tetratinite on an industrially relevant timescale. The researchers successfully created an iron-nickel alloy with an L10 structure similar to natural tetratinite by melting iron, nickel, and one or more optional elements such as titanium, vanadium, aluminum, boron, carbon, molybdenum, iridium, and or niobium, and then slowly cooling and applying a magnetic field and tensile stress. When improved and scaled, this alloy has the potential to reduce the need of rare earth magnets in applications such as electric motors and other areas where permanent magnets are crucial. Rare earth element free design. Magnets can be replaced with rare earth element free equivalents, but entire designs can be modified to eliminate the need entirely. Manufacturers can minimize demand and optimize their rare earth element supply chains to more dependent applications by improving on existing technology and reducing reliance on rare earth elements. With these rare earth element alternatives, there's a high chance that in the next few years one of these will hit the production floor. But, what do you think of these alternatives? Do you agree that we just change the rare earth elements? Or is there a certain need in redesigning the electric motor itself? Which do you prefer, permanent magnet motors or induction motors? Let us know in the comment box below. And if you've watched up to this point, thank you so much. For more videos about EVs, Toyota, Tesla, Ford, and the most recent auto news, please consider subscribing to Tech Addicts.